Bless the Lord who forgives all my sins.
Mercy endures forever.
Almighty God, to you all hearts are open. All desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Holy God, holy and mighty, holy immortal one,
have mercy upon us.
Holy God, holy and mighty, holy immortal one,
have mercy upon us.
Holy God, holy and mighty, holy immortal one,
have mercy upon us.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O God, by the passion of your blessed Son, you made an instrument of shameful death to be for us the means of life. Grant us so to glory in the cross of Christ, that we may gladly suffer shame and loss for the sake of your Son and Savior, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Ghost, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
Please be seated.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. Listen to me, O coastlands, pay attention, you peoples from far away. The Lord called me before I was born. While I was in my mother's womb, he named me. He made my mouth like a sharp sword. In the shadows of his hand, he hid me. He made me a polished arrow in his quiver. He hid me away. And he said to me, you are my servant Israel, in whom I will be glorified. But I said, I have labored in vain, I have spent my strength for nothing and vanity, yet surely my cause is with the Lord, and my reward with my God. And now the Lord says, who formed me in the womb to be his servant, to bring Jacob back to him, and that Israel might be gathered to him, for I am honored in the sight of the Lord, and my God has become my strength. He says, it is too light a thing that you should be my servant to raise up the tribes of Jacob and to restore the survivors of Israel. I will give you as a light to the nations, that my salvation may reach to the ends of the earth. Thus says the Lord, the Redeemer of Israel, and his Holy One, to whom one deeply despised and whored by the nations, the slave of the rulers. Kings shall see and stand up, princes, and they shall prostrate themselves, because of the Lord, who is the faithful, the Holy One of Israel, who has chosen you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Preface psalm for this evening, Psalm 71, verses 1 through 14. We will read this responsibly by whole verse. In you, O Lord, have I taken refuge. Let me never be ashamed.
In your righteousness, deliver me and set me free. Incline your ear to me and save me.
Be my strong rock, a castle to keep me safe. You are my crag and my stronghold.
Deliver me, my God, from the hand of the wicked, from the clutches of the evildoer and the oppressor.
For you are my hope, O Lord God, my confidence since I was young.
I have been sustained by you ever since I was born. From my mother's womb, you have been my strength. My praise shall be always of you.
I have become important to many, but you are my refuge and my strength.
Let my mouth be full of your praise and your glory all the day long.
Do not cast me off in my old age. Forsake me not when my strength fails.
For my enemies are talking against me, and those who lie in wait for my life take counsel together.
They say, God has forsaken him. Go after him and seize him, because there is none who will save.
O God, be not far from me. Come quickly to help me, O my God.
Let those who set themselves against me be put to shame and be disgraced. Let those who seek to do me evil be covered with scorn and reproach.
But I shall always wait in patience and shall praise you more and more.
A reading from the first letter of Paul to the Corinthians. The message about the cross is foolishness to those who are perishing, but to us who are being saved, it is the power of God. For it is written, I will destroy the wisdom of the wise, and the discernment of the discerning I will thwart. Where is the one who is wise? Where is the scribe? Where is the debater of this age? Has not God made foolish the wisdom of the world? For since, in the wisdom of God, the world did not know God through wisdom, God decided through the foolishness of our proclamation to save those who believe. For Jews demand signs, and Greeks desire wisdom, but we proclaim Christ crucified, a stumbling block to the Jews, and foolishness to the Gentiles. But those who are called, both Jews and Greeks, Christ the power of God and the wisdom of God. For God's foolishness is wiser than human wisdom, and God's weakness is stronger than human strength. Consider your own call, brothers and sisters. Not many of you were wise by human standards. Not many were powerful. Not many were of noble birth. But God chose what is foolish in the world to shame the wise. God chose what is weak in the world to shame the strong. God chose what is low and despised in the world, things that are not, to reduce to nothing things that are, so that no one might boast in the presence of God. He is the source of your life in Christ Jesus, who became for us wisdom from God and righteousness and sanctification and redemption, in order that, as it is written, let the one who boasts, boasts in the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Wordly and fittingly proclaim his gospel. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to St. John.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Among those who went up to worship at the festival were some Greeks. They came to Philip, who was from Bethsaida in Galilee, and said to him, Sir, we wish to see Jesus. Philip went and told Andrew. Then Andrew and Philip went and told Jesus. Jesus answered them, The hour has come for the Son of Man to be glorified. Very truly, I tell you, unless a grain of wheat falls into the earth and dies, it remains just a single grain. But if it dies, it bears much fruit. Those who love their life lose it. And those who hate their life in this world will keep it for eternal life. Whoever serves me must follow me. And where I am, there will my servant be also. Whoever serves me, the Father will honor. Now my soul is troubled, and what should I say? Father, save me from this hour? No, it is for this reason that I have come to this hour. Father, glorify your name. Then a voice came from heaven, I have glorified it, and I will glorify it again. The crowd standing there heard it and said that it was thunder. Others said, an angel has spoken to him. Jesus answered, this voice has come for your sake, not for mine. Now is the judgment of this world. Now the ruler of this world will be driven out. And I, when I am lifted up from the earth, will draw all people to myself. He said this to indicate the kind of death he was to die. The crowd answered him, we have heard from the law that the Messiah remains forever. How can you say that the Son of Man must be lifted up? Who is this Son of Man? Jesus said to them, the light is with you for a little longer. Walk while you have the light so that the darkness may not overtake you. If you walk in the darkness, you do not know where you are going. While you have the light, believe in the light so that you may become children of light. After Jesus had said this, he departed and hid from them. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Father Kevin said earlier, welcome to Holy Tuesday.
Again, welcome to Holy Tuesday. I feel like this is the calm before the storm, a time for prayer and meditation to get us ready for the emotional roller coaster of the betrayal of Jesus, Maundy Thursday, Good Friday, the great Easter Vigil, and Resurrection Sunday. This evening's gospel should sound familiar to you. For those of you counting, this is the third time we've read it in the last 10 days. I told that to Father Kevin, and he said, brother, that means it's important. In the gospel, we learn that some Greeks wished to see Jesus. Tonight, I want to talk to you about events in which we see Jesus and others in which we don't see Jesus. In the 1999 film entitled The Green Mile, there's a character named John Coffey, initials JC, who is wrongly convicted of a crime and put to death. Does that sound familiar? As his death draws near, John Coffey reflected. He said, mostly I'm tired of people being ugly to each other. I'm tired of all the pain I feel and hear in the world every day. There's too much of it. As I was preparing to give my first sermon last December, Father Kevin told me to preach from the heart. Well, tonight my heart aches. My heart aches for the victims of the massacres in Atlanta, Georgia, as well as Boulder, Colorado. I don't think we see Jesus in the actions of the shooters. I don't think Jesus was in the heart of these troubled young men. Have any of you heard of an 11-year-old boy named J.J. Whitmer? He lives in Brighton, Colorado, which is about 30 miles from Boulder, Colorado. When his mother explained to him that a shooter had killed 10 people at a grocery store chain that they frequent, young J.J. Whitmer felt sorry for the grocery store workers who had to return to work the next day. So he asked his mother if he could distribute flowers to the employees to cheer them up. The grocery store florist gave his mother a discount, and he distributed a flower to every employee. Some stated that they teared up as a result of the gesture. We see Jesus in the actions of this young boy, as well as the grocery store florist. My next example is not meant to be political at all. The state of Georgia recently enacted legislation to limit when and where its citizens may vote. Whether this was necessary, I have no idea. They also made it a crime to give food or drinks, including water, to people who are standing in line to vote. I don't see Jesus in that provision of the law. Remember, it was Jesus who said, "Whatever you do to the least of these, you do to me." I can't help but think that if young J.J. Whitmer saw people standing in lines for hours to vote, he would offer food and drink. In Georgia, he would be arrested. So as we continue our journey toward the cross, let's look for Jesus. Let's open our hearts and welcome him in. As today's psalm tells us in its first verse, "In you, O Lord, have I taken refuge. Let me never be ashamed." Let us pray. O God, you have made us in your own image and redeemed us through Jesus, your Son. Look with compassion on the whole human family. Take away the arrogance and hatred which infect our hearts. Break down the walls that separate us. Unite us in bonds of love. And work through our struggle and confusion to accomplish your purposes on earth, that in your good time, all nations and races may serve you in harmony around your heavenly throne. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Please stand for the prayers of the people. The Savior of humankind, by dying, destroyed death, and by rising again, restored life. Let us humbly ask him.
Redeemer of the world, give us a greater share of your passion through a deeper spirit of repentance,
so that we may share the glory of your resurrection.
Look with love on those who suffer because of our indifference.
Come to their aid and turn our unparing hearts to works of justice and charity.
You humbled yourself by being obedient, even to accepting death, death on a cross.
Give all who serve you the gifts of obedience and patience and endurance.
Transform the bodies of the dead to be like your own glory.
And bring us at last into their fair church.
For what else shall we pray? I pray for this parish. I pray for all those who cannot be here tonight. I pray for those who are here tonight. Who are sick, all those this night that will lose a loved one and suffer grief. Pray for the homeless. I pray for the angry. Give thanks for those who are experiencing joy in their lives. Give thanks for our high school seniors who are graduating and looking forward to the next chapter of their life. Give thanks for our staff and our volunteers, for the ministries of this parish. Most of all, I give thanks for your love. Father, may we receive your forgiveness and mercy as we celebrate the passion and death of the Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
We pray to you also for the forgiveness of our sins. Have mercy upon us,
most merciful Father. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone. And so uphold us by your Spirit, that we may live and serve you in newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy on you. Forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ. Strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
I want to thank you all again for joining us tonight, either in person or online. There was a good number joining us last night online, so it's nice to have you with us. A couple quick announcements, just a reminder, tomorrow, Spy Wednesday. What is Spy Wednesday? Someone asked me, is there like a special thing about spy? No, it's quite simply because Judas was a spy, so they named it Spy Wednesday. Spy Wednesday is the day that Judas agrees to sell Jesus and have him arrested. But it's also a day that we anoint the sick. So I encourage you tomorrow, if you would like to come and be anointed. St. James tells us that if there be any sick among you, call upon the priests of the church, and the prayer of faith shall save the sick, and their sins will be forgiven of them. So I encourage you, if you would like to come out tomorrow and be anointed with oil, we will do that tomorrow night at 7 o'clock. So please keep that in mind. Also, we are open to hear confession this week as we come into Easter. This is the time of the year when many will come and make confession and receive absolution. And I am available for that at any time. Just call and we will set up a time together. And then the Triduum starts on Monday, Thursday, from Mandate, the mandate from Christ. So we will gather on Thursday and celebrate the Lord with foot washing and Holy Communion together. So we'll have that set up here for you if you'd like to come and join us in person. And then Good Friday, where we will remember the death of our Lord and remember the sacrifice that his death gave for all of us. We will wash the altar, we will bury the cross, and venerate the cross together in a very, very holy and solemn time. Probably, in my experience, one of the most solemn and intimate moments with the cross that I've ever experienced in my life is on Good Friday. And then Saturday, the great Easter Vigil, Charlie Brown. Come and join us at 9 p.m. I was talking to Father Michael today from St. Luke's. They have some folks who will be joining us. And he said, couldn't you make it earlier? I said, no. So 9 p.m. on Saturday. We look forward to a wonderful time together as we start in darkness and we have new light of Christ, and we proclaim the exalted for the first time. And how long has it been, Elaine? Over a year that we've had holy water in the baptismal font, at least. Close to a year and a half, maybe. So this is a big night, and I'm excited for that. We'll have the new Paschal candle lit, and we will make new holy water for baptisms. And it's just going to be a time of coming into darkness, but then entering into the resurrection. And then, of course, Sunday morning at 10 a.m., as Galen said, Resurrection Sunday. I know we call it Easter Sunday, but I just like to call it Resurrection Sunday, because it's the day that we know that our God is alive. So please put those on your calendar. We still have some space if you'd like to come to any of those masses on the Triduum. Just shoot us an email at rsvp@standrewspickerington.org, or just call or text me, and I'll be sure to put you on the list and make sure we have a space for you. I think that's it. Walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us as an offering and sacrifice to God. Lord, forgive me of my sins and cleanse me of my iniquities. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give him thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, through Jesus Christ our Lord. For our sins he was lifted high upon the cross, that he might draw the whole world to himself. And by his suffering and death, he became the source of eternal salvation for all who put their trust in him. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever say this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Holy,
holy,
holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Holy and gracious Father, in your infinite love you made us for yourself. And when we had fallen into sin and become subject to evil and death, you in your mercy sent Jesus Christ, your only and eternal Son, to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. He stretched out his arms upon the cross and offered himself in obedience to your will, a perfect sacrifice for the whole world. and the night he was handed over to suffering and death, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine. When he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ has died.
Christ is risen.
Christ will come again.
We celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O Father. In this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, recalling his death, resurrection, and ascension, we offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be for your people the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life in him. Sanctify us also, that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. And that the last day bring us with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Saint Andrew, and all your saints into the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ. By him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen.
Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Christ, our Passover, is sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us keep the feast.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Grant us peace.
The gifts of God for the people of God. Body of Christ, the bread of heaven. The body of Christ, the bread of heaven. body of Christ, the bread of heaven. The 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 body of Christ, the bread of heaven. Let us pray. Eternal God, Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and you have fed us with spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now to the world in peace, and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Bow down before the Lord and pray for his blessing. Almighty God, we pray you graciously to behold this your family, for whom our Lord Jesus Christ was willing to be betrayed and given into the hands of sinners and to suffer death upon the cross, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon you and remain with you always. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.